Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to do a video on melting down, smelting, and refining some gold.
So here's some vials that I've had for quite a few years now, and they're mostly gold, but there's some black sands mixed in with them. Some have rusted and gotten all chunky. Some are wet, some are dry. And so we're going to take all these, melt them down, and make one nice gold button that we can then further refine by cupelling. So our first step is going to take all those vials. I'm going to take the plastic lids off. They're glass vials, and so I'm going to just put them in the bottom of our crucible here. And since some of them are wet and some of the gold's all stuck in there, I'm just going to break the glass up, and then we're going to warm it up and drive off the water and get it all dry, and then we'll mix it with some flux.
All right, so now we have our gold down in there and crushed it all up, all the vials, and we got a hell of a mess going, but we're going to dry it all out. And this is the same crucible I'm going to be smelting it in, so even if there's some gold stuck in the bottom, it should all be contained in the button at the end. All right, so there's our crucible. We got a little wrap of KO wool around it for insulation, and we're just drying out the gold and the glass in there, and I'll mix up a flux recipe here, and then we'll get to smelting. All right, here's all our broken glass and gold, and I have 300 grams of Chapmans flux I'm going to put in there. And I'm going to add about another 100 grams of borax to help with the glass that we put in there. That'll help keep everything fluid and absorb some of that silica from the glass. Okay, we just got her in the furnace, and it's just starting to heat up. So we'll check in with it in a bit.
Our charge is now coming up to temperature and starting to melt. And it's important to remember that when you load a crucible, only load it about 2/3 to 3/4 full, because all this gas you see coming off our crucible now tends to make it boil, and if you have too much material, the material will actually boil over and get all over the inside of your furnace. Now the material's come up to temperature, it's all melted, but you're still seeing these big burps in the middle of the crucible. And I ran it about another 5 minutes longer, and those burps went away. So once the charge went nice and quiet, then it can be poured into our cone mold. Here's a look at our steel cone mold, and it's something I just fabbed up out of steel plate. And the idea is that when you pour the molten material in it, all the densest material, the gold or the other collector metals that you have, are going to go right down to the bottom of that cone mold. And it's really important to remember, heat your cone mold up, get it warm and dried out, but not really hot, because if it gets too hot, it's going to fuse all the material you pour in there, and it'll be really hard to knock out. Okay, we just got her in our cone mold here. And there's the pattern that forms on the surface as it's cooling. So we'll let this cool down, and then we'll see what we got in the bottom of our cone. Our slag is cooled down. You see it's starting to break up there. It's real nice and glassy, nice and uniform. And so I'll dump this thing over into this tub here, and hopefully we'll see a big gold button in the bottom. And there you go. We'll get it knocked off of there and see what we got. So there's our gold chunk in the bottom. And there's a little bit of slag on it, on the surface, so I can get it knocked out of there and chip some of that slag off, and we'll get her weighed. All right, there it is, all cleaned up. We'll get it on our scale here. grams. Okay, now the question is for you guys, I have this gold bead. It's probably mostly gold, 75%, 80%, 90%, somewhere in there. I can cupel this and remove any additional base metals. The silver will stay in there, but I can increase the purity a little bit.
or I could just send it right off to a refiner. And because we're experimenting here, I'm going to cupel it and remove the base metals. But what do you guys think? Should this be refined further, or should I just send this off to a refiner, get paid 90 to 95% of the gold value, and not even worry about refining it anymore? So leave a comment below and let us know what you think. I've just made a little cupel here, and I'm going to put our gold button and some metallic lead in there. And I made it out of just Portland cement. This is stuff I went to, you know, Lowe's or Home Depot and bought. It was like 12 bucks. And we're going to put the gold bead in there. See if I can dig it out of here. So here's our gold bead. And I'm going to put it right in the center of our cupel like that. I'm going to cut up some lead. This is just roofer's lead. I'm going to cut up, I don't know how much base metals is in there, so it's going to be kind of hard to tell, but I'll start with about 50 grams of lead. It's about a 50 gram button, and we're going to melt it down together, and as the lead heats up and melts, it's going to oxidize, and when we get it to a high enough temperature, the lead oxide is going to start to melt and then roll off the lead kind of pool we have there and get absorbed by the Portland cement, and any base metals, copper, lead, zinc, antimony, bismuth will go with the lead and get absorbed into the cupel, and we'll be left with a pure gold and silver button. Now the first thing you got to do is you got to dry out your cupel. I've actually made the mistake of putting lead and gold in there in a wet cupel, and as you heat it up, the moisture bubbles out from underneath and spits little beads of gold and lead all over the place. So you want to make sure you get your cupel pretty dry and warmed up before you put your lead and your gold in there. Here are two buttons. The one on the top is the one we just smelted, and the one on the bottom is one that I've cupelled in the past. And you can see there's a little bit of a color difference. It looks like the one we just smelted might have a little more coppery color to it. So I'm going to cupel the bigger one and see if we can remove some of those base metals.
Our lead is melted now, and it's going to start to dissolve that gold bead we put in there. And you can see on the right side, it's just starting to form a black oxide film on the surface. This has been sped up four times to show the lead actually dissolving our gold bead. The black oxide is now thick on the surface of the lead. Our gold bead has just been dissolved into the lead now, and the lead is starting to open up and show clean, bright lead on the surface, and all the oxides are starting to roll off our puddle and be absorbed by the cupel. Now the hot, bright lead is really starting to drive, and you can see the oxides forming on the surface and rolling off very quickly into the cupel. And the cupel is starting to form a black ring around the lead button, and this is where the oxides have been absorbed into the cupel, and once the lead is completely oxidized, we'll be left with a nice clean gold button. As our bead gets smaller, the texture on the surface actually changes, and just before it goes to gold, it kind of gets this iridescent rainbow color on the surface, and then the bead will actually freeze in place, and that's when you know that it's done cupelling and all the base metals have been removed.
And so of course my battery died just as I was finishing up, but here's what came out of the furnace. It's that nice shiny gold bead. And this ring around the bead is where the lead was absorbed into the Portland cement there. So let me see if I can pop this thing out of here. There we go. Let's get out here in the light. There you go, there's that shiny yellow
gold color we're looking for. So let me get the scale and we'll see how much it weighs. Hey, we're zeroed out. Here's our gold button. Before it weighed 46.03 and now we're at 43.32. So we lost just shy of 3 grams of base metals, but it turned it nice and gold color and shiny. So I'm going to take this over and see if I can get my guy to shoot it with the XRF gun and see exactly how pure our gold is here. So there you go. We took our vials of crappy, rusty, wet, dirty gold dust and little pieces and melted them down, turned them into a real nice, shiny button with no base metals. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.